I'm dying. I need to get this down before the pain overwhelms me. I can't believe that I was finally able to drag myself out of that vat. The slime did not affect me, but I nearly drowned. I don't know what happened to Harold. He was standing right next to me when the crane knocked me into the vat. He must have been killed, or he would have tried to help me. Francine is dead, killed by one of those robots. I have no idea how much time has passed. I was able to hack the computer to turn off the robots and record this, but now my mind is slipping away. There is much pain. The green slime that I was immersed in is the source of all the mutations we traced to here. My skin is starting to fester and peel. In other areas, it is bubbling and is expelling a green, mucus-like substance. Some days, the pain is almost tolerable. I can actually walk a few steps again. It seems inconceivable that I dragged myself all the way up here from the vat room. Strangely, I'm actually feeling stronger, though I'm still in a lot of pain. Everything seems to be getting smaller. I think I consumed one of the mutated things scurrying around here today. Before I knew what was happening, some sort of tendril had sprang from my stomach and covered the poor creature. As soon as it had sucked the rodent into my gut, I could actually feel its mind, I think. There is the very real possibility that I'm going slowly insane and can no longer differentiate between what is real and what is a hallucination. Maybe I'm still slowly dying in the vat, and I've imagined all this. Things are becoming more clear to me every day. This toxin has actually improved my mind. I feel that I can understand even the most complex philosophical questions simply and directly. It's as if all the layers of artifice have been stripped away. I wonder what would happen if I submerged an animal in the vats for a prolonged period of time. Would it gain awareness? The strangest thing is happening to the animals. They actually become smarter and more aware of their surroundings. I dipped a dog and a rat at the same time today, and they were fused together. It's not quite two creatures anymore, but it's more than one. Perhaps this is the future, a coming together of different creatures in some sort of harmonious unity. I no longer consume the different animals I create simply for sustenance. I have become the instrument through which unity will be achieved. I am so much more than a human being now. It is time to bring others into the glory that is the unity. A lost soul has finally strayed into my home. I was so surprised I consumed him before dipping, a mistake I shall not make again. His mind was so primitive as to be repulsive to my refined cognitive abilities. I've begun to modify myself to be more pleasing to the unity by injecting small doses of the virus into my body. The slime in the vats is a man-made virus called the forced evolutionary virus. This information was acquired from my newly grown neural link with the base computer. The few wanderers that have found their way here have been a disappointment to me. They can't seem to mutate correctly. The best I've been able to create are some big and dumb mutants. Most can recall nothing from before I initiated them into the wondrous unity. I only feed on them for fuel now. Their minds are nothing to me. Oh, glorious creator, I have succeeded in spreading the complete joy of unification to another soul. Unlike the others, his total radiation count was low. I believe this is the factor we have been overlooking all this time, as it seems the conversion is more successful in the cases with less radiation damage. I have never known such glory as I felt when taking his mind into our own. We are beginning to create an army dedicated to unifying the wonderful diversity of life. We have trained them to continue our work here while we search out more populated areas to take into ourselves. We are beginning to feel the limitations of a body that is mobile. We must find a permanent home with a greater store of knowledge and a steady supply of biomass. We have stopped increasing ourselves until we can find this new unification center. When we have arrived, we will continue to grow and feed until we have brought
peace
and unity
to the entire wasteland.